From the 1011 Now Streaming Studio, this is The Nightbeat.
Good evening, I'm Danielle Schenk with your headlines for Friday, October 11th. The Nebraska Supreme Court's decision on the voting rights of thousands of felons remains in limbo. This case arose after the legislature eliminated the waiting period for felon voting, which the Attorney General deemed unconstitutional, leading to a lawsuit against the Secretary of State. Now, Regina Wright, who served her felony sentence over a decade ago, is unsure if her vote will count. Both the Attorney General and Secretary of State argue only the Pardons Board can restore civil rights.
I felt defeated. This country is supposed to be a country where you can make mistakes and start over and fresh, but unfortunately, it seems like it's not like that anymore.
With voter registration deadlines approaching, Regina and voting rights groups say the decision can't come soon enough. And the Secretary of State claims about 100,000 signatures on two medical marijuana petitions may be fraudulent, while those behind the initiatives accuse him of undermining the process. A Lancaster County judge overturned a motion to dismiss the lawsuit today. Bob Ebnin's team cited evidence of several notaries violating the law and requested a handwriting expert to review the signatures. Medical marijuana attorneys argue the state's actions are unprecedented, but did not object to the motion. Now in Fillmore County, the sheriff's office says a man has died after his combine caught fire earlier this week. It happened around 11 a.m. on Wednesday, northwest of Fairmont. First responders were initially called to a large grass fire and discovered the combine in flames. They found the operator, 92-year-old Harold Cool Sr., dead inside. Investigators believe a mechanical issue may have caused the fire. New details are emerging about an alleged Omaha kidnapping that has landed three people in jail. Ashley Bordeaux appeared in court today, her bond set at $1 million. She, Jared Pappin, and Devon Spera face charges for a September 6th kidnapping. The victim says she was selling an iPad when the suspects zip-tied, blindfolded, punched, and burned her. She escaped after being held for about 3 hours, running into a nearby Casey's to call for help. Now in much lighter news, kombucha may not be the first drink that comes to mind at a brewery, but Hastings is home to Nebraska's only brewery making its own. First Street Brewing and Ensign Beverage Incorporated have partnered to create this unique drink, with a portion of each sale supporting Husker Athletics through the 1890 initiative. Their first flavor, Champions Cherry Limeade, was actually inspired by the Nebraska volleyball team. Rounding out your night beat is a check of the 7-day forecast.
You've been listening to The Nightbeat. Watch, listen, and stream on the 1011 app on YouTube or wherever you get your podcasts.